My name is Mary Matsuda Grunwald. I'm 87 years old, and I live in Seattle, Washington. I grew up on Vashon Island. This is a small island in the Puget Sound, about a 15-minute ferry ride from Seattle. Mm-hmm. And I grew up on a 10-acre strawberry farm. And I went to grade school and was in high school. I was a junior in high school at the time that Pearl Harbor took place. President Roosevelt declared war, and so that meant that those of us who looked like the enemy became suspect. President Roosevelt ignored the information that was gathered by the naval authorities several years before December 7th, in which they determined that there was no Japanese problem on the West Coast. And that information was given to President Roosevelt, but he ignored that and was influenced severely by the fear of the American people that there would be an aggression on the West Coast and an attack on the West Coast. And plus, this was an election year. President Roosevelt did not listen to the naval intelligence, but he did listen to John D. DeWitt. And on February 19, 1942, he established the order, Executive Order 9066, which authorized the Army to remove all Japanese from the western parts of Washington, Oregon, Arizona, and all of California. We, of course, knew we had 8 days to get ready, so it took quite a bit of thought and planning to finally decide what we were going to take.
Well, I bought the building in 1985, I think, to save it for history and education. So Mr. Horry, who I'm buying the building from, said a friend of his asked him if he could put his things in the basement. He said yes, and this friend told this friend, and this friend told this one, and this one. Pretty soon it was full. And then, so when I first saw it, it was still full. This was 1984.
When we left our home, we had to leave our dog and our cat, and we walked about a half a mile, and then noticed these Army trucks, and that's when we knew that we were now prisoners of war. We were given these tags, and we had to write our family name, Matsuda, M-A-T-S-U-D-A, and our family number, 19788, on each of these three tags. And two of them went on the two suitcases that each of us carried, and the third one we had to put on our buttonhole so that the soldiers could tell who we belonged to. As far as island people itself, we were treated very, very well. And so the Seattle side of the Sound, that's when we noticed the sharp contrast in the people's behavior. And there were all these people, I mean, there were lots and lots and lots of people who came down to watch, and they were silent. But we were escorted by the soldiers. There were these men, scruffy-looking guys with guns, and this one just shouted at us, you know, "Get out of here, you goddamn chaps!" You know, just very, very scary. The other men didn't say anything, but they spit at us. silent crowd, we didn't know if they were against us and were glad we were being taken away by the soldiers, or if they were sympathetic to our situation. But because they didn't say anything, they didn't make any noise, it just felt strange and hostile and scary. What it meant to be an American. It meant that I had all of the privileges and the responsibilities that every other citizen has. First day of school, we were required to pledge allegiance to the American flag, and, you know, that just ticked me off because I was a citizen, treated like an alien and put behind barbed wires and then required pledge allegiance to the American flag. I mean, I was just really angry. But as you probably read, you know, my mother toned me down, realizing that, you know, there's nothing that I could do about that.
Everybody says nobody wants to talk about it, but maybe if they talked about it, maybe we wouldn't have to keep repeating it, because everybody would then have some understanding or knowledge about it.
It started out as a feeling, which then grew into hope, which then turned into a quiet thought, which then turned into a quiet word, and then that word grew louder and louder, till it was a things changing doesn't mean it's never been this way before. All you can do is try to know who your friends are as you have.